to get your blood flowing, your brain working, whether it's weeding a garden, which I know weeding a garden is not something that we all may want to do. But just little things to get you up, get you moving, get the circulation going. So it's actually had a study that people that have exercised regularly and just light aerobic exercise have done better on cognitive tests than people without exercise. And I know that may blow your mind that exercise is good for you. Who would have thought it? So now we're going to move on to the food part, which I'm more familiar with. I am certified as an executive chef and also as an executive pastry chef. We're not going to be talking too much about the pastry aspect because it's not very good for you. But we have a few things that you should try to implement into your diet as a part of healthy heart and healthy brain foods. Believe it or not, good fats. There are fats out there that are good for you. You have omega-3, omega-6, and DHA. These are all good fats, and very important to at least try to get into your diet a couple times a week. These fats are found in fatty fish or fish oil, if you take fish oil. But what I was talking about was the good fats, like omega-3s and 6, that are found in things like fish oil, flaxseed oil, ground flax seeds, seaweeds, walnuts. These are good things to implement into your diet. Also fish. Fish is extremely, extremely good. Nitrates, beet juice, or if you don't like beet juice, there are other things you can eat. Cauliflower, broccoli, and spinach. Vitamin B12. I'm sure everybody takes some type of vitamin B12, right? Hopefully. Well, multivitamins do not supplement for eating healthy. So, by any means, I'm not trying to talk you down from taking multivitamins. They are good, but you still need to eat healthy and exercise regularly. But what we're going to be talking about today is a salad. It's a spinach salad, which you can get your nitrates from. It does have toasted walnuts, which we just talked about, and it will have a maple dressing, also blue cheese crumbles. It's a really, really nice salad. It's really simple, and I saw everybody had paper and pens, so I'm sure you could write this down if you want to. It's a really delicious salad. Okay, so first thing we will need is baby spinach.
All right, the first thing he's getting is baby spinach. So if you like spinach and you like salad, this might be the salad for you. Always wash the spinach, he's saying, before you use it. Most of us know this, but never bad to remember to wash whatever you're using first. So he's adding the spinach to his bowl. He's gonna now add blue cheese crumbles. So he's got his spinach leaves that you can probably pick up at any Kroger, Target, Walmart that has a food area. And now he's adding the blue cheese crumbles. Which could you use other cheese, Justin, if you... You could use maybe feta. You could use feta, so other cheeses would work. But this one will have blue cheese in it. The blue cheese, he says, complements the dressing, so he's a chef, he knows better than we do. And now he's going to be adding toasted walnuts to the salad, so if anyone's going to try this, if you have a nut allergy, please just be aware, there will be toasted walnuts in the salad. B6. B6, walnuts have B6 in them, B6 vitamins, so they're, which are memory boosting, B6.
Okay, now we're gonna start on our dressing, which it is a vinaigrette. So remember, anytime you're working with a vinaigrette, if you make it ahead of time, shake it or whisk it really well before you serve it. But it's really, really simple. We have three main ingredients. We have olive oil, we have maple syrup, and we have apple cider vinegar. You can substitute the apple cider vinegar, but this salad, when I designed it, it was really to complement everything in the ingredients. So what we have, if you want to write this down, the basic recipe is a quarter a cup of olive oil, a quarter of a cup of maple syrup, and 1.5 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar. That's it. Real simple. Anybody can make this. I've obviously multiplied it out by a few, so hopefully we can get as many people to try it as possible. But here we go.
So Justin's gonna be making a couple plates that you can try. If we run out of samples, there are Edwards coupons up here, Edwards Steakhouse coupons for quite a bit of people. So feel free to come up and get a coupon or get a salad to taste. As soon as he's finished, we'll put some salads that you can try right here on the stage.
I'm actually gonna get Tiffany to help me on this one.
Uh-oh.
Typically, when you add a vinegar to your dressing, you want to add it last. Slowly add it while you start to emulsify it into your dressing. And remember, like I said, it is okay to make this ahead of time, but if you do that ahead of time, remember, please shake it or stir it before you serve it, because the vinegar and oil will soak it. Once you have your dressing all ready, you can serve it on the side. I know a lot of people like dressing on the side, but this is meant to be more like a Caesar dressing where it's actually served on the salad. So don't be scared and go ahead and just top it on.
So now he's putting the dressing on the salad. And we'll go ahead and get some plates and forks available for those that want to try it.
Thank you.